Getting paid to sit at home. That's what one state lawmaker says too many Iowans are doing. He argues that they are working the state's unemployment system instead of actually looking for a job. KCCI's Max Deeknight is in the newsroom tonight. And Max, the lawmaker thinks he knows how to stop it, but his idea is facing some backlash.
Well, Steve, Republican Senator Jim Carlin says hundreds of people are blatantly applying for jobs they're not qualified for here in Iowa just so they can meet the requirements for unemployment benefits. He wants to impose a three-strike rule, but he does face some opposition.
There are people who do know how to game the system.
It might discourage people from taking a chance on a job.
I don't think it's unfair.
Senator Jim Carlin recently wanted to hire a paralegal for his private practice, so he posted the job online. He says he had to sift through hundreds of applicants, many who weren't remotely qualified.
I began to wonder why, over a period of weeks, why are we getting all these people applying for this job?
Carlin says he talked to other business owners statewide who are facing the same issue.
They know what they're doing, and they know how to get the benefits, and they know the rules very well, better than most employers do.
He's proposed a bill that would allow employers to report such applicants to the Iowa Workforce Development. If someone were reported three times, they'd be investigated and could lose their unemployment benefits. The employer would have to show the applicant either doesn't meet lawful requirements or is, quote, manifestly unqualified.
That's entirely subjective and up to the employer.
Charlie Wisham of the Iowa AFL-CIO says that language is way too broad. He says while some people are gaming the system, this could hurt those trying to better their lives.
We just don't want to see people not taking a shot, not taking a risk, when we are, you know, we hear constantly about that we have a shortage of skilled workers. We want people to take that shot.
Now, there is currently a way employers can report questionable applicants to the state, but this bill would impose a consistent penalty. Steve?